do the traverse method through plane table survey. So here let me just see the different points. So I am standing at point A, that is point B, point B, point C, and here there is a point D. So I am standing at point A, B, C, and here there is a D. So according to traverse method, we have to set up the instrument at every station point. So at this place, we just remove this ranging rod and we place the peg, right? So we place the peg here at the same point. So I'm going to remove the ranging rod at A point, and then we fix the peg. Then after, we are going to set up the tripod. We are set up the tripod exactly over that point. So here, when we are setting up the tripod, we have to just confirm one thing, that your peg should be towards this side so that we can easily accommodate the whole place on the plane table, right? So one thing is required, you should place your peg at some eccentricity, right? So this one is your AD line, this is your AB line, and that is your C line. So it means that it is the extreme survey line, right, of the field. So we are going to place this point aside one point, right? Then we place the drawing board, that is a plane table, so by using this butterfly nut, we are going to just fix this plane table with the tripod. Now when we set up this plane table, we are going to level this drawing board. So before leveling this plane table, we just set this point in such a way that is a peg. We set this peg in such a way that it should remain towards this shorter side, because this is your A, this is your A, that is your D, right? So it means if we set the A point somewhere here, then there will be a AD line, right? When we do the take the observation using the LED, then this will be your AD line and this is your AB line. So we are going to set our plane table in such a way that our survey line AD and our survey line AB will accommodate within the drawing sheet, right? So okay, so we set up this point somewhere here, right, so that it could be accommodated the line A, D, and AB. Once we set up the instrument at the A point, then after we are going to do the leveling. So to do the leveling, we just put our bubble tube in such a way that parallel to the longer side. So this one is the longer side. So we put our bubble tube parallel to longer side. Then after, we unclamp or loosen the butterfly, and then we make it parallel to any 2 foot screw, to any 2 foot leg, right? This two leg, right? With parallel to this 2 foot leg, like this. Then after we observe the bubble, right? So bubble is towards right side. It means that this part is at the higher elevation. So we are going to rise the opposite leg and we bring the bubble at the center. Right, so now bubble it at the center. Then after we put this bubble tube parallel to the shorter side, the shorter side, and then we observe the bubble. So bubble is towards this side. It means that this is at the lower elevation. So we are going to just move this remaining leg only. And bring the bubble at the center. Bubble is at the center. Then after we again check at the longer side, it is at the center. Right. So our plane table is now leveled. Then after we just bring the plane table. We bring the plane table. We bring the plane table in such a way that D, B and C, that will be accommodated. So see, we have the point somewhere here. So when we just bring that peg, right, using this U fork, using the U fork, we'll bring it is exactly at the center, and now we are going to claim the butterfly nut, ensure that butterfly nut is claimed, and look at here, your plumb bob is exactly at the center of the peg, and the same point is displayed over here, right? So we just fix the thumb pin at this point, and then we remove this U-fork. It means that now your peg is exactly on the drawing sheet, and then after using the truck compass, we are going to mark the north, right? We are going to mark the north. So we just loosen this screw, unclamp the needle, and then we just rotate the needle in such a way that it will be at the zero. Now is it exactly at the zero? So we just draw, we put like this, and then we just draw one line and we show the north. So this is your north. So once you have the north, then after using the LED, so this one is the LED, so you just open up the crosshair and open up the your eyepiece. Then we just put this LED in such a way that through this split, and this is the crosshair, we bisect the point, that is a B, that is B point. Right. So what we will do, we just put our LED tangential, we put the LED tangential to the thumb pin, and then after we just observe, from the split, through the split and the crosshair. So we are going to match that, crosshair with the ranging rod at the B, crosshair at the B. So it is match with the crosshair and the ranging rod will become in one line, and then we just draw a line, simple line, and here we have the line, and we just mark here, that is AB rays, right? This is your AB rays. At the same time we have another rays, that is the D rays, AD. So your crosshair is matched with the D point, and then we draw the line, right? And we just mark it as the AD rays. So we have two rays, AD and AB. Then we are going to measure the linear measurement using the chain, and whatever the dimension, that will be plotted right on that particular point, postcard. Simultaneously we will do the chaining, right? So we do the chaining, and we'll measure that what is the length of line AB. So now we are going to do the chaining. Completed the orientation of AB and AD, we'll remove the peg, and at the same place we will place the ranging rod. So this is our point A, right? So we have done the, we use this LED to have the line AB and AD. Then we fix the ranging rod exactly at the same point. So this is our A point, and now we shift our instrument to the B point. Move the ranging rod, and we will fix the peg right at the same point. So now I'm going to remove the ranging rod at point B, and I'm going to fix the peg at the same point. Then we put the ranging rod. Then we just fix up this. We set up this instrument in such a way that, in such a way that so this is our line AB, right? Rays AB, and that is our point A. And this is line AB. So now we remove this thumb pin from the A, and then we set our instrument in such a way that your, so the length of AB is, so the length of AB is 25 meter and 25.60. So this is 25, this is 25. We are going to take the scale is equal to 1 centimeter, 1 meter. So 25 meter and 25.5, and this one is 25.6 meter. So this is our point B. Then we are going to fix up the thumb pin exactly at this point A. Once we fix up that point A, then we just level this instrument using the, but one thing is required, that you should just randomly or approximately put, we just put this LED in such a way that it will be in the parallel to this line. You put exactly over the line AB, and you just put the LED tangential to point B, and then we just try to rotate it in such a way that it will be coincide with the A. Now in this case we have to recentered the plumb bob, right? So we put the plumb bob and we match now. So it is centered with the A. But look at here. Look at here. That is at some distance. So in this case, what we will do? We'll just try to unpin the drawing sheet. We remove the drawing sheet clips on all sides, and then after we just remove this thumb pin, and then we just hold this U fork at the position and just roll or switch our drawing sheet and bring that point exactly at the B. Now see, it is been leveled. Then after we just bring that point exactly at the B, and then we fix up again the thumb pin. Then after we remove this, see, now point B is at the place. Then we remove this U fork, and using the LED, we put this LED parallel or over the line AB and put it tangential to the point B. And then after we look inside the your eyepiece and the crosshair, and then we just rotate this whole sheet, right, and make the crosshair parallel coincide with your point at A. So it means that we have reorient our sheet. So once you have the reorientation, then after we clamp your drawing sheet using the drawing clip at the all sides. So we are going to now verify again the plumb bob whether it's at the center or not. Okay, it is exactly at the center. Once the centering and orientation is completed, then after we'll take the observation of line AC. So this is your B point and that is your C point. Then we just draw the line that is BC. This is your line BC. Then after we do the chaining from B to C, and then after with the 1 centimeter, 1 meter, we will take the C point, right? And then we move this instrument from B to C.